Hi everyone, it's Tara from North Austin Music Therapy. Today I'm going to share 5 helpful tips on how to have a meaningful video call with your loved one in long-term care. So tip number 1, you want to limit distractions. Now this goes for both sides of the call. So you want to make sure that you're in a quiet space as well as your loved one's in a quiet space, that there's no radio or TV on in the background, that there aren't people walking all around and, you know, if they're in the dining room and dishes are being done, that kind of a thing. Better for them to be in their rooms, better for you to be in a quiet space in your home. Number 2, you want to speak clearly and pause in between your statements. And there's a couple reasons for this. One of the big reasons is just the tech. You're going to have that delay with talking with somebody on video. So you want to give them enough time that they can hear out your statement, that you can hear them, and you're not interrupting one another. And the other thing is you also want to be aware of any information processing delays that your loved one might have. So you're going to have to give them additional time to not only hear what you're saying, but process what you're saying and then respond to you. And with that tech delay, that might be a little bit longer than it is when you're talking to them in person. So number 3, prop up your phone. I know this sounds silly and most people will just hold it, but if you start to move it around, your loved one might feel like they're on a boat or a ride, and this way it's steady and you don't have to worry about it and you can just talk through it that way. Number 4, if audio and video don't match up, so this is something that can happen if the connection gets weak or something going on with the delay. So I might be talking, but the words aren't matching what my mouth is saying. So if that happens, your loved one might become frustrated. They might become confused at what's happening. And to be honest, there could be many reasons that they're becoming frustrated in the call. If they can't hear you clearly, if they can't see you, if they're unsure of the tech. So if any of these things happen, just remember you can take a pause, you can take a breath, and you can stop the call. Call back later, try a different time of day. You don't wanna force the video call because you don't want them to be upset and never wanna do it again. You want this to be an exciting and a fun experience for them. So just keep that in mind. Number 5, this is probably the most important tip that I'm going to give you. Make the calls fun and not clinical. All day long in long-term care, your loved one is being asked all sorts of clinical questions. So think of fun topics to talk about. See if they're going on any trips or outings. What's the local gossip going on in the community? Did any friends or family come to visit? Did anybody special come in and do a special program or entertainment or music therapy for them along the way? So you want to ask them about their day and you want to share your day as well. So the fun parts of your day. After you've had several phone calls with a loved one, then bring in the grandkids, bring in the pets, you know, video from being on vacation and showing them your lake view. Once you're comfortable, be able to visit with them in lots of different ways. And the other thing I wanted to share is if a loved one is unable to carry on a conversation, or if you ask them how their day was and they said, it was fine, and then that's all you get from them, then you want to keep that conversation going. So show pictures of loved ones and family members from when they were younger and share stories. If you're working on a hobby, show them anything you've done with woodworking or quilting, or if you're learning guitar, sing a song with them. If you bought a new fishing pole, whatever the case may be, just make it fun and keep it simple. You know, you want to have a meaningful conversation and that can look a lot of different ways. So above all, try to have fun with it and hopefully you can incorporate this into a new routine for you and your loved one. If you're looking for more ways to meaningfully engage your loved one, you can contact us through our website at northaustinmusictherapy.com. Be sure to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel. Happy trails and take care.